Hi food scrapers, I'm Eike from Bulle Kulinarant. So today I'm gonna explain you a bit the feelings on the first day in Japan. So it's my first time here in Japan. It's already the third day, but I really wanna summarize what I experienced here in the first days. And this first 2 days, they already feel like 1 or 2 weeks. That is so amazing. So first of all, to ride the subway is not as easy as you think, because after I arrived here and wanted to go to the hotel from the airport, the first problem was that the alarm was going on at the subway because of me, because I just passed through the second gate. So I swiped my card, and just directly after it, 5 meters behind it, there was another gate where we would have to swipe the card. But I saw that the exit door, so I wanted to go through there, but this gate was closing, and I kicked it open and the alarm was ringing and like some voice and okay, there was no one coming, no security guard. I also didn't realize in that moment that it's not the exit door. So I went down to the train, but as I was there and I was chatting with my girlfriend and explaining my experience, I just realized, wow, wait, I'm now at the train, so there's something wrong. That wasn't the exit door. So I went back and asked the security guard. He checked my card, and indeed, I didn't swipe the card, and he swiped it for me, so it wasn't a problem. The next day, I wanted to go 2 stations with the subway, and I bought in this vending machines. I bought a ticket. I didn't know I wanted to top up my card, but I bought a ticket. That was really strange. But I had luck, because of this security guard there, he realized my situation and he refunded me the money and helped me on the machine to top up my card. So now I know how to top up a card, but honestly, it's not as easy as everyone is saying. And I've been to a lot of countries, but here it's different because you can't really read the signs. That's really hard. Point two, here in Japan, they love vending machines. You will see it when you arrive at the airport, you directly see it. They have vending machines for everything, for SIM cards, for drinks, for umbrellas, for I don't know, but they have everything in there. Also toiletry, and women need stuff and many things. They love vending machines, and you see it everywhere around here. I think you can't really walk in a street without a vending machine. They have so many of it. So guys, because we just talk about the machines, so here you will find the first one. Behind this white house is the second one, and just 20 meters. There you find another one, the blue one. That's again just 20 meters from the other one. So you see, you have vending machines everywhere in Japan. They even have restaurants where they have the vending machines in front of the restaurant, and you have to order and pay with this vending machine, and later just give your ticket to the staff there. I think that's really interesting. That's really cool. I'm not so sure why they really love vending machines, but okay, that's good. Third point, which I realized here, they have a strong beer culture, and they also drink beer during the day for lunch. They also snacked like takoyaki and have beer with it. I really love it. I love this beer culture. I hear it also in the evening normally. They go to the izakayas and have a lot of beer there, so they don't directly go home, but having some beer first. But this beer culture, wow, I'm really impressed. It's really cool. Point four, I visited many countries in Southeast Asia, but Japan is the first for me where I really don't understand anything, because I have the Japanese signs, and that's what makes it for me a real adventure to be here. And I'm so grateful that I'm allowed to experience this here in Japan, because it's an adventure when you go to a restaurant or anywhere and you don't understand what you get there. You're mostly lucky at the restaurants that they have pictures in the menu, or they have sometimes this plastic fake food in front of the restaurant. You can just throw in it, and the good thing is you see the price there, how much this is. But mostly, if there are no pictures, I'm just looking for, okay, what might be the cheapest or the most for the value, and I just choose that one, just throw on it, and they know what I want. Mostly it's working. Sometimes you're getting not really what you want, but mostly it's working that you're full after that. Point five, because we just talked about restaurants, the prices here in Japan are all without tax. So there's always tax, I think it's 8% added in the moment when you want to pay. So it's not the real price which you see there. You just have to add 8%. I'm always confused with that one, but yeah, so it will work out almost. Yeah, just take 10%, and that's easy to calculate. Point six, so for me, Japan is a mixture of Germany and Singapore. I mean, it's really quiet here. Like in Germany, the traffic is really similar to Germany. They have a really defensive driving style here, so they're really careful. Yeah, but I really feel a bit like home when I'm here. That's quite strange. I didn't expect that, to be honest. I didn't expect that. It feels a bit like in Germany. Also, the weather is similar. I would say at the moment really similar to that in Germany. So it's warm on the day, and at night it's getting fresh. Number seven, guys. I realized the Japanese people are really, really incredibly helpful. Yeah, they always try to help you. I think many people can't really speak English. It's also like in Germany, most people can't speak English, or they can understand but afraid to talk. So that's what I realized here. That's a bit hard. Communication is hard here, but they really want to try to help you, and I really appreciate that. That's really cool, and I think I have to learn more Japanese actually to also respect their culture, to respect their language. I really have to learn more Japanese. Yes, definitely. Okay, guys, for the beginning, that's the first 8 points which I realized here in Japan, which are really special, I think, here in Japan. And I will update you with another video after I got more to see here, because at the moment, I mean, it's just 3 days. I just saw the downtown area. Today I'm going to the more rural area. Not really rural, you see it behind me. I will stay in this area tonight. I will update you, and if this video helped you, please give it a thumbs up. I would really appreciate it. And if you have a friend that wanna go to Japan, or maybe is living in Japan, please feel free to share this video. And also don't forget to subscribe below, because you're gonna get more tasty content, more food videos, and a lot of travel from Japan and also other countries. Okay, guys, thank you very much for watching this. I hope we meet again in the next video. Let's get it tasty, guys.